Thank you. Ah, there we are. Hey. hey, YouTube. How's it going? Hopefully y'all can hear me out there. Let me know if you can hear me. I got my YouTube chat up right here. So, anyway, welcome. Hopefully, I just got to make sure y'all can hear me before I think this is working. Hold on. 1 second. Yeah, now there should be sound in from the game at least. Oh, geez. You know, you think I'd have this down pat by now. Hi, yes. Sounds like you can hear me, yeah? All right. Well, that's good. All right. Anyway, hi, I'm Gearheart. I'm the videographer for the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe, which you probably already know what it is if you're here right now. This is our theater. Let's see here. Here we are, in the theater. This is the lounge. If you'd like to join the theater itself, feel free to come and try to get a seat. We've had people not show up, so you could come here into Rec Room and, actually join in, which would be really cool. But for now, we will be, sitting here in the lobby for a little while we get everybody ready. For the show. So feel free to just, you know, look here in into the lobby while we get everything going, okay? Thank you for interrupting my intro, Joker. That's our board operator. all right. Anyway, yeah, sit tight. We'll be starting up soon. Thanks for your patience. And I'll just
here you are. Hi, Gear.
Hello. stream cam, this is stream cam.
Dreamception. Here, tell me about what's your question? What's your question that I'll go ask? Yes, you are. We are actually streaming it on YouTube right now. But yeah, feel free to if you want.
Oh, there you go, YouTube. It looks like they want you to have some of that pizza, so... All right. Well, we're still getting ready, so just hold tight, okay, out there on the internets? Enjoy the antics of these crazy kids in the lobby here. Look at that guy.
How's the camera doing today? Thank you.
Wizard hat guy, are you gonna take that from him?
Alright everyone, I'm going to be sending out party invites here very soon, so please check if you are currently in a party. If you are, please leave it.
Yeah, let's get Make sure your wristband is brown.
Yeah. Your face is still dumb. The less you can hear me, the more dumb your face is.
Gear, can you hear me? I'm right here. I'm flying above you. Behind not that you. Far above you. Soul Reaper, Loon Tune, you guys need to leave your parties.
Go to your profile and your watch.
There they are. No, that's not what I wanted to press. Oh well. Party invite.
Gossip Angel, you need to leave your party.
Banana Boy, I just sent you a party up request.
You need to leave your party.
Check your watch.
Open up your profile underneath what? The save outfits button. Yep, there you go.
No!
Are you ready?
Nope, you gotta be in my party. You're not wearing a monocle on that eye anymore, now you're wearing a contact. It is whenever you have a cork fly into it.
Hey, YouTube, we're making dumb jokes. Apparently, I have monocle contacts
right,
now.
Here? We got... Is there a I'm confused. Is there a confused lizard in here?
Oh. Yeah, it's you. You're the confused lizard.
I am not. I'm a drum geek. I know who I am.
Yeah, I know who you are, too, you lizard. Oh, there's a photograph. Look at this photograph. It's me. It's a photograph of me.
We both made that joke at the exact same
moment. I'm sticking to my face so everybody knows who I am.
It says right here your Noah Expo.
Yeah, that's whoever Noah Expo YT is. That's me now. I've assumed your identity.
Fun fact, we actually have just enough slots for everybody that's currently in the room.
Wow!
To join us.
Well, I sure am glad everybody got in here. Yeet! I can't hear you. Oh, that's I'm you? I'm you now? Okay. I need your clothes and your motorcycle.
Yeah, let's go ahead and everyone just start partying up.
Yeah, everybody punch me! Not the face! Not the face! Not the face! Oh god! Not the face! Ah, help! Oh god! Ah. Oh. That was a bad time. Oh boy, let me just sit down in my chair again. Oh. Gosh, YouTube, don't, yeah.
Wait, right.
All right.
Yeah.
Just don't ever say everybody punch me. All right, okay. We have orange wristbands, yeah? Is it orange? Is orange our color this time?
Orange.
Looks like orange. You came here dressed for it, man. You were ready. Look at that guy. He was like, yeah, the wristbands are orange. What are you asking for? Of course they're orange. This guy's got it too. Oh, man.
All right, everyone, check your wristbands. Make sure you have the right ones. We are heading to the theater.
Oh, see you there.
Woo! Oh, someone party up with Eric. If he doesn't get left behind, it'd be really bad if we didn't have Marty.
Fair enough.
Alright, YouTube, we're headed to the theater now. I'm gonna get you guys the best seat in the house. Let's go on over there. Alright, hi there. Hello. Just a heads up, this is the filming seat. So I'm gonna have to ask you to head to a different seat. Okay. Thank you very much. All right, here we go.
Sorry, I lost the reserve sign to put on that seat.
Oh man, Pigeons! I told you to put that thing on like a string or something.
Who was in your seat? Gear?
That guy.
Help me.
Get him out of here! All right, let me switch to a first person view here for the good old YouTube there.
Let's see here.
That's a camera. Yeah, let's hear from that camera. That sounds good. Give you guys a good old frame rate.
Do not get under the seats. Do you know how much like old gum and stuff is down there? I mean, it's just disgusting.
And that's really impressive because we just renovated this place. It just kind of grows there.
Well, I renovated. I didn't say I cleaned it.
That's fair. That's fair. Yeah, Drummer Geek is responsible for these comfy leather seats that he made himself.
Made out of the actual leather? Real pigeon killer leather.
Yeah.
It's pigeon killer leather.
You won't believe how many times we had to tag IKP out in paintball to furnish this theater. It's crazy. Ah! I suppose I deserved that one, but YouTube didn't deserve that one.
Yes, they did.
Oh.
I wanted them to feel like a part of it. It's like 3D. It's 3D. It's like it's coming, really coming at you. Ha!
You can go in your back.
You feel like you're part of the show.
And I still have being
I am part of the show. I'm the cameraman.
See?
Ah, my face.
I also have a gold potion that apparently still has 2 days on it that I forgot about.
All right, YouTube.
Wait,
I'm gonna go
was
quiet.
Mr. Bob Ross in the room earlier?
We're gonna get ready to. Get ready to get in there and watch this show, okay? Alright, boop.
Everyone, find a seat.
That's my bone. Maybe on the last performance. Next one's the last one, right?
I think. Actually,
the last of the scheduled ones that we've had.
We have somehow ended up with one too many people.
YouTube could do it without me, right?
Hey, Bob Ross, were you just invited into the room or were you actually on the event?
I think that's a new person.
I'm not seeing your name on the... And you weren't in the room when we jumped. Are you talking? Because I can't hear you. That's fine.
The profile picture is just as scary as
what's
the
up?
Day that we took it.
My profile picture really is horrifying. I'm never gonna change it.
It's like when people call
hold up.
Hold
up, we got an underage child here. We're gonna have to report. I love the cosplays, you guys. I love it.
People are cosplaying our characters? How cool is that?
Well, actually, wait, quick question. Said you're about to switch to screen mode? Since we have another person in VR who wasn't in the room we jumped, we have one too few seats. Would you mind watching it on the YouTube? Because watching on YouTube is about the same as being in the theater on screen mode.
Yeah, it
is. That's how we do the YouTube stream. Yep. But we have someone on VR who's... And you're gone.
Okay. That settles that.
I'm going to take a yes.
Yeah.
Mr. Bob Ross?
Mob Boss.
You have this seat right here.
His name is Mob Boss, you dyslexic panda.
I'm actually going to set the maximum occupancy in this room.
Oh, okay. Quite the crowd today. Hello. Hi, everyone. Hello. Howdy.
Okay, so there's, what?
Oh, yeah.
11
I tried.
Plus 14.
Ooh.
Yeah.
All right. Audience, I'm just letting you know now that I personally... Hello,
what
pigeons.
Is that?
Hi, YouTube.
Yeah, here, yeah, here. I personally have you all muted. It's not a personal decision. I still love all of you, but I want the viewers on the fine sight of YouTube to be able to hear the show in its entirety without hearing any chatter over top of it. Not that I would insinuate that you guys would chatter. I probably will unmute you guys at the end of the show just because we want to hear you guys cheer, you know? Even on YouTube, I bet. They want someone to cheer with, so I'll just let you guys know that now, okay? So if you're trying to talk to me, it's not gonna happen. Also, watch out for that guy. He's dangerous. I don't know who keeps giving him guns.
True.
Yeah. Stuck.
Hey,
on
drummer.
The invisible wall.
Yeah. Remember that person you were talking to?
I know. I saw. I'm not sure how to deal with him right now.
I can go talk to him.
We don't have enough.
I can go talk to him.
Okay.
So hey. We have very limited seating capacity. And watching on screen mode is basically the same experience as watching the YouTube stream. Which is why we're limiting it to... Anyways. Which is why we're limiting it to VR only. And so we let in another VR player in. So if you don't mind, go watch it on the YouTube stream. It's... Yeah, I heard the headset died, which sucks. But
he's on screen mode. It doesn't change the fact that the experience...
Right, like watching on the stream is basically the same experience as watching on a screen mode.
Yeah, and having too many people in here impacts the performance of the whole room.
Yeah,
we can't have extra people in here, sadly.
Yeah, so our stream is youtube.com/c/orangebucketactingtroop. And it's streaming live right now. Thank you so much. I know. I got no control over them charging their Quest headset, though. Like, yeah. I mean, it's unfortunate.
We're not being mean because they're the screen mode players. It's not a case of like, oh, you don't have VR, you're right. Not allowed in the room. It's a case of the experience on screens is the same as watching the stream.
Right.
Whereas the experience in VR
is... We'd rather let an actual VR person in here because it feels like you're really here. Given how limited we have to keep the attendance. We had a couple of shows for the devs where we packed in like 30 people and it broke the room. So we can't have too many people in, unfortunately.
It wasn't even 30. It was only a few more than we have right now. It was only about 5 more than we had right now. It's like, we are at the threshold of what's capable, or what the room can handle.
Yeah, you're right. you mean George? You mean George?
What a buckethead. Who just told me to shut up?
Oh my gosh, it's Biff! Biff! Biff, can I get your autograph? By which I mean a fist bump? Oh, he's gone. Can I get a fist bump? Thank you.
Biff doesn't give autographs.
He doesn't give autographs?
You got the wrong guy. You got the wrong guy, Biff.
Was that him?
Oh, you missed him again! This is a terrible shot!
I don't care! By the way, this guy
He's
has
gonna
a great
take
outfit.
Out the entire audience.
This guy looks cool. I like him. I have a better idea.
I put on my room.
I know how to deal with this. I know how to deal with this.
Now, Biff, leave the kid alone! Come on, Biff.
That's it, Biff. I'm gonna...
You're gonna wear a bucket on your head is what you're gonna do.
Where's Emily? She needs to see this. One sec.
No. It's not what I do.
Oh.
Get over here! Aha!
I sent you an invite.
It's gonna distort. It's not a problem we can fix. Apologies.
No, the music is gonna get weird, but it's not gonna, like, it's not indicative of the room about to crash. Just try to ignore it as best you can. Yeah.
Well, I had to restart my entire computer because SteamVR refused to track, so...
Don't print out pictures, please. It impacts the performance.
I thought I had that. They couldn't. Did someone print out photos in here? Was that actually something that were people able to do?
Yeah, someone printed out a photo.
Who are they so I can ban them from the room?
It was Biff.
That buckethead. I would do something like that.
Yes, you would.
Wow.
All right, you know what? I'm going to sit in front of the front row. It's going to be a good show. When's it going to start? That's why wear a helmet.
Now they can't print photos. Helmet. Try it now. Don't have to tell me twice.
Damn it, Biff.
Where are the printed pictures at? Real quick before we
get
started.
I threw one into the void. I only found one.
FYI, throwing them into the void doesn't destroy them. They just fall into the...
Well, you know, I'm used to being in 2017 Rec Room, okay?
Yeah, because you're a buckethead.
When it did work. Ow.
Alright. Because he's a buckethead. Duh.
Biff is a bully. That's what he does. Are we missing Mr. Bob Ross? I noticed his seat is empty.
He crashed.
No, Mr. Bob Ross. He was Mr. Bob Ross. Mr. Bob Ross, the mob boss.
Mr. Bomb Sauce?
It was Mr. Mob Boss. That's funny.
Yeah, it was.
I blame Drummer for calling him that. That's what I keyed off of.
I blame Rec Room for having way too many Bob Rosses.
I mean, that's fair.
I almost bucketed Watts.
Are we waiting on anybody, or are we getting ready to go?
I'm ready to go when,
Let's get this word on the show.
We all good to go? Alright. Let's do it.
Got everyone here yet?
I think we're good.
Emily was... Is she here now?
Yeah, Emily's here.
Yeah, she is. Okay.
She's
excellent.
She muted herself. She's gonna keep quiet, but she's here. Alright. Hi guys, gotta get your attention. Hi everybody. So, my name's Joker, and before we introduce ourselves, and the production, I have a preface for some of the audience, especially those of you joining us on YouTube. Oh wait, I've got Gearheart blocked. Hi Gearheart, you can see me now, which is appropriate because I have an announcement for YouTube. Okay, so hello you. Oh, okay, that's good. That's good. Okay. Anyway, hi again, YouTube. I have a preface for everybody on YouTube and those of you in the audience. Orange Bucket Acting Troupe are players and community members of Rec Room, and Back to the Rec Center is in part a love letter to the Rec Room community, as was our production of The Princess Bride 2 years ago. And as such, we want to acknowledge that some of you folks may not be familiar with some of the common references in this production, but we want to assure you that there's plenty to enjoy. You might not be familiar with Alkmaar, our dear friend, questing buddy, and Rec Room staff member, who has a reputation for firm but fair conduct moderation. And you might not be familiar with Gribbly, creative director and founding member of Rec Room, or Votivator, friendly person and skilled software developer. We acknowledge that you might miss references to things like Frontier Island, or to Camp Lone Pine, which is one of our creepiest attractions, or to the various game glitches and exploits from over the years that have captured our imagination. But that's okay, because you will become familiar with people like Emily Waffles Yay and Delco, who we have here with us tonight as part of our crew. And more broadly, we assure you that this production was crafted in its most basic elements of love and good spirits, and that thus it has universal appeal to all good-natured people, no matter where you come from in virtual space. And now please welcome I Kill Pigeons to the stage to give a proper introduction to tonight's production.
Welcome! Welcome, everybody. One second. Biff, if you don't be quiet, I'm gonna...
Yeah, you're gonna tell Alkmaar, I know. You threaten all the time. You never do anything. Besides, well, I'm not scared of her.
Every bully with half a brain is scared of Alkmaar.
Well, I guess I don't have half a brain, because I'm not.
Well, we agree on that, at least. Look, the sooner you get off stage, the sooner we can actually start this show, and the sooner you can start bullying people, all right?
Fine, whatever.
Right, where were we? Apologies, we had a small technical difficulty, but everything is fine.
You're now. A small technical difficulty. You get it? You get it? Because he's short?
Right. Where was I? Welcome to the Orange Bucket Acting Troupe's latest production. This play lasts about an hour and a half and takes place in two rooms. Thus, there will be one room transition. I will alert everyone when that is about to happen. In the second room, the play will resume when everyone has returned to their seats. So remember where you're sitting and go back to that same seat. Please remain in your seat and do your best not to disrupt the experience for your fellow audience members. This includes not making unnecessary noise, like your mom yelling at you, or you yelling at your sister, or dogs barking, stuff like that. If there's a possibility for background noise, you should probably be on push to talk or just mute your mic. Now that said, we do want to hear your play-related laughter and you know, noise like that. So don't be afraid to laugh out loud if you find something funny, or you know, boo Biff when he's on stage, that kind of thing. Do not attempt to get on stage, and try not to move around. There really shouldn't be any reason to move around. Just stay in your seat. If you do need to move for some reason, try to do it when the curtain's down. The walking noise we cannot turn off, and it can be kind of disruptive. Excessively disruptive people will be kicked, and they might even be banned from future Obat productions. So please behave. We don't want to do that to anyone. There is currently a bug with some of the audio that might cause it to distort or sound odd. There's nothing we can do about it on our end, so please bear with us and be patient in the event of any other unexpected technical problems, although hopefully none will occur. Go into your watch and set your volume sliders to full, or else you might not hear some of the sounds and music we use in this play. Once you've set your volume sliders to full, go into the Advanced tab and uncheck Show Names. We have names turned off in this room, though due to performance reasons, the names pop on every now and then, and we don't want to have your immersion broken by, you know, I kill pigeons coming up over to someone who's supposed to be George McFly, for example. Without further ado, the Orange Buck Acting Troupe is proud to present Back to the Rec Center.
Truck invention in the merch booth.
Ooh.
One day, Jennifer. One day, I'll have enough tokens to buy that. Think about it. We could drive around Frontier Island Resort in style. Camping at Bucket Lake under the stars all alone. No one to bother us.
I'd like that. Ranger Roy says Frontier Island is really romantic and peaceful. Speaking of Bucket Lake, are we still going tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm borrowing George's car.
Save the go-kart! Save the go-kart! 3 years ago, a video of a go-kart session wreck was uploaded to YouTube. A few days later, Coach announced an update. I know in my heart it was the update that was supposed to bring go-karts. Save the go-karts!
What? Rec Room already lets us make our own vehicles. Give it a rest.
But a Rec Room original go-karts track would be so much better. Will you not upload my canny post and help me save the go-karts?
Alright, Watts, alright. I'll upvote your canny post, but no more asking about go-karts during AMAs, okay?
Thank you, kind sir. Here. Take a copy of this flyer. Share it wherever you can.
Sure. Whatever. Now, just get out of here.
Save the go-karts! Save the go-karts!
Okay, where were we?
Well, right about... It's my dad. I gotta go.
I'll message you tonight.
I'm playing on my alt account here. I'll just write it down.
You're listening to Rec Center Radio KREQ.
Get wrecked!
And now, the news.
Doc, officials at Medical denied a rumor that the shipment of missing Rectonium was in fact stolen from Cyberdark City 2 weeks ago. A group of lumberjack paintballers had claimed responsibility for the alleged theft. However, Medicorp now attributes the discrepancy to a simple clerical error. Rec Room support, who were investigating the matter, had no comment.
Doc, where you at?
Marty, are you here? Where are you? Ah, there you are, Marty. Excellent. Now, don't touch this adventure. It's unstable and might cause you to crash.
Yeah, thanks for the warning. So, did you want to meet me here just to show off another one of your unstable inventions?
No, no, no. I need your help with a different invention. Meet me at Camp Twin Pines tonight at 9 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time. And bring a holotar camera.
Sure, Doc. I'll be there. Perfect. Just perfect. Shut up.
I can't believe you lent me your car without telling me it had blind spots. I could have been killed.
No, Biff. No, I never noticed any blind spots when I drove it. Hi, Marty.
Are you blind? They're there. How else do you explain what happened?
Biff, can I assume that you're gonna replace my car with your tokens? It's half goblin.
My tokens? It's your car. You should pay to replace it, or get the goblins to do it. I want to know how I'm supposed to get the new A rank trophy gear. All the speedrunners are blocking me. Hacking your car was the only way I was gonna be able to complete it. How am I supposed to get the blue archer hat now? And where's my whiteboard art?
Well, I haven't finished drawing it yet, but I figure since the contest deadline isn't until next weekend...
Hello? Hello? Anybody home, huh? I gotta have time to save it as my own invention. Do you realize what would happen if the devs found out I was cheating in the contest? I'd get banned. You wouldn't want that to happen, would you? Would you?
No, of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen. I'll finish up those drawings tonight and hand them over first thing tomorrow, alright?
Alright, well, not too early. Plan on playing laser tag and reporting any teleporters to see. Why don't they just learn to use walking locomotion? I never needed a teleport. Hey, McFly, your shoes are untied. Don't be so gullible, McFly. We don't even have feet. Oh, I swear. I get your car towed all the way back to your place, and you don't even have root beer for me. Unbelievable. What are you looking at, Buckethead?
I know what you're gonna say, my friend, and you're right. You're right. But Biff just happens to be on the laser tag leaderboard, and I'm not very good at confrontations.
The car, George. He totaled it. It's got a giant boulder in the side. I needed that car tomorrow. Jennifer and I were going to take that to the lake together. Do you have any idea how important that was to me? Any clue?
I know, and all I can say is, I'm sorry. Lorraine, did you say something? I think you're on... Maybe your mic isn't working.
We'll have to eat this ourselves. I had to ban Carthage for impersonating a dev. Again.
Again?
Oh, hey, pizza. That almost makes up for the lack of... root beer. Oh, no pineapple this time.
Marty, instead of going to Bucket Lake tomorrow, why don't you and Jennifer create a minigame event instead? That's how George and I met.
Wait, I thought you guys met playing Golden Trophy.
Well, we did. I saw him in the rec center, except it was called the locker room back then. He looked so lost and nerdy in those suspenders that I took pity on him and invited him to play Golden Trophy with me.
Right,
while we played, he told me
story.
About a minigame he created.
He was such a noob at Quest that you felt sorry for him, but then decided to attend his event called Murder Mystery.
No, it was a murder mystery game called Coach's Dinner Party. It was my first mini game. I'll never forget it. It inspired me to create Minigame Mondays.
Yeah, those Minigame Monday videos were what got me to start playing that game. They were really good. If not for those videos, I probably would have never met you or George or Doc Brown.
Thanks, Marty. You're a good friend.
Oh, right. I'm supposed to meet Doc for something. I'll see you later.
Introduce my latest invention. This is the bigger one, the one I've been waiting for since I started playing Rec Room. Look. Here it comes.
A DeLorean go-kart?
Oh, bear with me, Marty. All your questions will be answered. Now start the holotype recording and we'll proceed. There we go. All right. Now, good evening. I am Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing at Camp Twin Pines. It's Saturday evening, October 26, 2020, 9:18 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time. And this is temporal experiment number one. Now, please note, the DeLorean clock is precisely in time with my watch. Got it?
Right. Check, Doc.
Okay. Now, when this thing hits 8.7 meters per second, if my calculations are correct, you're gonna see some serious shit. Oh, yes, we did it! 8.7 meters per second! Why did I tell you? Oh.
You disintegrated the DeLorean.
Ah, no, Marty. The DeLorean is perfectly fine.
Where is it?
Ah, not where, but when is it? I've just sent it into the future! Precisely 1 minute into the future, to be exact.
Wait. Doc, are you telling me you built a time machine into a DeLorean?
Well, the way I see it, the Cybertruck hasn't been released yet, so if I want to travel in style, the DeLorean will have to do. Oh, look out! Hey! It's back! Oh, look! The clock's exactly 1 minute behind my watch now, and still ticking! We did it! Come on in, I'll show you how it works. Alright, first you turn the time settings on, and then you input your destination time on this keypad here. Let's see. Here's a red letter date in the history of Rec Room Science, March 5th, 2017. Yes, of course, March 5th, 2017.
I don't get it. What happened on that day?
That was the day I invented time travel. I remember it vividly. I was in the locker room, using the chair glitch to climb up to the ceiling, when I fell and hit my head on the basketball hoop. When I came to, I had a vision in my head of the flux capacitor, the machine that makes time travel possible.
Flux capacitor?
It's taken me almost 3 years and most of my tokens to realize the vision of that day. My coach, has it been that long? Oh, things certainly have changed around here. Ranger Roy used to own this campground. He had this crazy idea about breeding pine trees. And I kept trying to invite people to camp here, but no one would because there were rumors that it's haunted. Eventually, he moved to Frontier Island instead.
This is heavy, Doc. This is great. Does it run on normal gizmos?
Oh, unfortunately, no. It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity they require.
Rectonium? Doc, You can't just walk over to the merch booth and buy Rectonium. Did you rip that off?
Well, of course, from a group of lumberjack paintballers. They wanted me to build them a power weapon, so I took their Rectonium, put a laser pistol inside a leaf blower, and told them that was a power weapon. Now, put on some S-Rank whiskey. It'll protect you from the Rectonium's radiation. We have to load the time machine. There we go. Oh no, I seem to have left the Rectonium behind. These other ones are all glued into the box for safety. The one I wanted was right here, but it's gone. Oh, where did I leave it? I must have fallen out of the box on the way in. Ah, there we go. I found it. It was back here in the woods. I got it. Okay. Here we go. Very volatile stuff. You gotta be very careful with this. Here we go. And even when it's empty, we'll put it back in the case just to be safe. There we go. All right. We're all fueled and ready to go. Get your camera. Let's continue. Now,
all right.
I, Dr. Emmett Brown, I'm about to embark on a historic journey. Oh, wait, what was I thinking? I didn't think to bring any extra Rectonium with me. Oh, how do I expect to get back when pilot one trip? I must be out of my mind. Oh, my coach. They found me. I don't know how, but they found me.
Who? Who found you?
Who do you think? The lumberjacks! Run for it, Marty! I'll draw their fire!
No! Bastards! What do you keep up with this?
What?
Who are you? A hacker? You're moving without teleporting.
No, I'm not cheating. I'm sorry about your tent.
That's it. This is the last straw. I'm sick of your kids trashing my campground. Right there. No! My pine! You killed my pine, you hacking son of a witch!
Oh, this cannot be happening. This is a nightmare. Wait, is this a public lounge? Hey, Healthy Moose. What's today's date?
Today's March 5th.
What year?
2017, duh. Hey, cool outfit. Where'd you get it?
Thanks, it's from a quest.
Hey.
Huh?
Yeah, did you just come from a paintball game or something?
What?
What's with that outfit that's all painted neon?
Oh. I'm looking for someone. Doc Brown? Would you happen to be friends with him?
Nope. Sorry.
Oh, mate, could you check your recent people list? Maybe he was in here.
Listen, are you gonna order something, or...?
Yeah, give me a root beer.
Beer? If you want beer, play Sports Bar VR. And here, we pour water.
Hey, McFly! What do you think you're doing?
Biff?
Hey, I'm talking to you, noob! Did you email AG support like I told you until you falsely reported me the other day?
Well, actually, I figured I could wait till Monday since I'm hosting another Coach's Dinner Party minigame this weekend.
Hello? Hello? Anybody home? Huh? Think, McFly, think. If I get too many reports on my account, I'll get banned. You wouldn't want that to happen, would you? Would you?
No, no, of course not, Biff. I wouldn't want that to happen.
What are you looking at, Buckethead?
Hey, Biff, check out these guys. Questaba, he stole nightlights on it. Dog's afraid of the dark.
So about that email?
Okay, Biff. I'll tell AG Support tonight that it was me that falsely reported you so that you can play tomorrow without getting another ban.
All right, you better. Plan on playing paintball and spawn camping some noobs in the morning. Hey, McFly, your shoes are untied. Don't be so gullible, McFly. We don't even have feet. Hey, I don't want you hosting any more of your minigames, all right? That last coach's dinner party was a disaster. Everyone left after I showed up.
What?
You're George McFly.
Yeah? Who are you?
Hey. What do you let those boys push you on like that for?
Well, they're a higher level than me.
Stand tall, buddy. Have some respect for yourself. Let me know. You let people walk all over you right now. They'll be walking all over you the rest of your life. Hey, look at me. You think I'm going to spend the rest of my days in this flophouse? Not me. I'm going
Watch
to
it,
learn
Youngie.
How to organize PvP tournaments, and one day, I'm going to do something great for the Rec Room community.
Wait, that's right. He's going to start a paintball league.
Yeah, I'm... A paintball league. I like the sound of that. I could start a paintball league.
A paintball league, that'll be the day.
You wait and see. I will start a paintball league. It'll have the best paintballers in Rec Room competing against each other.
Good! You can start by going to paintball and leaving my customers alone!
Paintball league. I like the sound of that.
George! Hey George, wait up!
You there! Do you want to play Quest with me? It's too hard for me to beat by myself. Oh, wow! I've never seen an outfit like that before. Where's it from?
It's from Quest! He said so! A Mystery Samsara Special S-Rank Reward!
Oh, wow! He must be pretty good at Quest, Marty!
Huh? Oh, yeah, I've played it a lot. Oh, Lorraine! Do you know Doc Brown? I need to find him.
Yeah, my recent list says he's in Shield Soccer?
Who actually plays Shield Soccer?
It's gotta be a bug. He's probably in paintball or 3D charades.
Thanks.
I'll send you a friend request. We should play Quest together soon.
Doc?
Quiet! Quiet! Don't say a word! I don't want to know anything about you!
Doc, it's me, Marty. You gotta
quiet,
help!
Quiet! Quiet! I'm going to read your thoughts!
Ah!
Don't tap my side! Oh, that was the wrong bucket. Here we go. This is the one. Here, now, put this on your head. It won't hurt, I promise. Put that on. I'm going to read your thoughts. Stick it on your head. Go on. That's right. Okay, now, let's see. You have come from a great distance.
Yeah, exactly.
Ah, good. Don't tell me. Let's see. Subscriptions. You want me to buy a subscription to Rec Rumor Magazine?
No.
No? Okay, let's have another look. Donations. You want me to make a donation to the Adjective Animal Sanctuary?
Doc, I'm from the future. I came here in a time machine that you invented. And now I need your help to get back to the year 2020.
Great Scott! Do you know what this means? It means this damn thing doesn't work at all!
Doc, you've got to help me. You're the only one who knows how your time machine works.
But I haven't invented any time machine. I don't know what you're talking about.
All right, look, I'll prove it to you. Look at my level. I'm level 42. Everyone else here is still capped at level 20. I have other features from the future. I can change my clothes without going to my dorm room. See? I can change from teleport into walking locomotion like this. I can summon a camera with my hands.
Oh, you can you? Those are some pretty mediocre tricks there. You could be just using some play-space mover or something to do that walking around and some other hack to change your clothes and, mess with your level number. I'm not convinced.
I'm telling the truth, Doc. You've got to believe me.
Well then, future boy. Who is the community manager in 2020, huh?
Mama Monkey.
Mama Monkey? The dodgeball, huh? Who's on the support team? Delco? I suppose Harry Manlegs runs the YouTube channel or something. I've had enough practical jokes for one evening. Good night, future boy.
Doc, wait. The bruise on your head. I know how it happened. You told me the whole story. You were using the chair glitch to climb to the roof of the locker room, and you fell off a chair and you hit your head on the basketball hoop, and that's when you came up with the idea for the flux capacitor, which is what makes time travel possible.
My coach!
And that's why I need your help getting back to the future. Hey, Doc, why did you put your lab in shield soccer? Isn't that dangerous? Anyone can come in here. It's a public room.
Oh, no. It's the safest place to experiment with my exploits and hacks because nobody ever plays shield soccer. Look, my latest invention, double shot rainbow bow.
Okay.
Double shot rainbow bow. and Bobo.
Double
go
shot?
On, give it a try. Double shot. Shoot two arrows. Go on. No, 2 arrows. Shoot 2 arrows with it. That's odd. I swear it was working yesterday. Must have been or something. Anyway, now, show me this time machine you've been talking about.
Oh, right. Yeah, let me pull it out. I have it saved in my watch as an invention.
You can save things in your watch? Fascinating. Oh, wow! Look at this! It works! Oh, I can't believe it! I actually invented something that works!
I bet your ass it works. I have a holotar recording you need to see.
Huh? Oh. Okay. This looks like it should be able to connect it up to the scoreboard projector here. Yes, there we go.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown.
Oh, look.
I'm standing at camp.
It's me. Oh,
it's Saturday evening.
Coach, I've still got my hair.
2020.
What is that outfit I'm wearing, though?
Groom standard time.
That's the same gear you had on when you arrived here.
Experiment number one.
Yeah, that's Eshrin Quest gear. It's supposed to protect against radiation.
Oh, of course, yes. From the fallout of all the Goblin Wars.
This is a
holotar. It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity they require.
To make them what? The what? Rewind that.
Unfortunately, no.
Play it again.
It does use gizmos for movement, but the time circuits are powered by rectonium. I need a nuclear reaction to generate the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity.
1.21 gigawatts? 1.21 gigawatts? Oh, great Scott! Oh, 1.21
What the hell is a gigawatt?
Gigawatts? Oh, what was I thinking? Oh, 1.21 gigawatts? Oh, how could I be so careless? That kind of power? Oh, how could I generate just... It just can't be done! You can't generate that kind of power, Marty!
Doc! Doc, look, all you need is a little rectonium!
Oh! Huh. Yes, I'm sure in 2020, little rectonium is available in 2-star boxes as a treat, but I'm afraid in 2017, it's a little hard to come by! You're stuck here, Marty, I'm sorry!
Whoa. Whoa, Doc, stuck here? I can't be stuck here! I got a life in 2020. I got a girl. She's crazy about me. Look. She wrote, "I love you" on the back of this poster board. That says it all.
Some slippery on this. Thought these were meant to be sticky. Terrible. Oh, what's this? So on the back here, you say, let me see. Oh, well, Marty, I'm sorry, but the only power source capable of generating 1.21 gigawatts of electricity is an announcement from Coach. The power of love? That's just not enough.
Wait, what did you say?
I said the power of love is just not enough.
No, right before that.
We need an announcement from Coach. That's the only thing that can generate that kind of power. Unfortunately, you never know when one will happen.
We do now.
Oh, yes. Oh, I see. Yeah, this is it. This is the answer. Ah, it says here, an announcement from Coach is going to happen at approximately 5:04 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time next Friday. Wait, an update on a Friday?
Yeah, the devs learn not to do that in the future.
Well then, yes. If we could somehow harness the power of this announcement, channel it into the flux capacitor. It just might work. Next Friday evening, Marty, we're sending you back to the future!
Hey, that's amazing. Friday's good. I mean, I can hang out in 2017 for a week. You could show me around. We could do some questing, attend some mini games.
Out of the question! You must not leave this room. You must not see or talk to anybody. You must not have any fun. Anything you do could have serious repercussions on future events. Do you understand? And make sure you use teleport instead of that walking locomotion thing. You don't want to get banned.
Right. Sure. Okay.
Oh, and Marty, have you interacted with anybody else besides me today?
I sort of ran into a couple friends that I know in the future.
Oh, great Scott! Ah, Marty, change your clothes again!
Why, I can't.
Marty, how did you first find out about Rec Room?
I saw some Minigame Monday videos my friend made and wanted to check the game out.
What? Yes, just as I thought. This fits with my theory. First, your camera gesture didn't work, and now you can't change your clothes outside your dorm room.
The saved outfits button's gone. Like, it's been erased.
Erased from existence! Doom, doom, doom! Marty, remember, according to my theory, you have interfered with your friends' first meetings. If they don't meet, Lorraine won't convince George to host another coach's dinner party. And because she doesn't attend that, she won't start hosting Minigame Mondays. You won't see those videos, which means you're going to keep losing features from your future account because you will have never started playing Reco in the first place. Unless you repair the damage, your entire account might disappear. It'll be like your Reco character never existed at all.
This is heavy, Doc.
Oh, now is not the time for lifting weights, Marty. Give that here.
That's George over there. George! George, remember me? We met in the public lounge earlier.
Oh, yeah. I remember you.
Good. You know that girl, Lorraine? She told me that she really wants you to host another coach's dinner party so she can attend.
Really?
Oh, yeah. All you gotta do is go over there, tell her you're hosting a murder mystery event, and invite her.
What? Commit to hosting event right now? What if she doesn't want to attend? What if no one shows up? What if Biff shows up and ruins it again? I don't think I can take that kind of rejection. Besides, I think she'd rather go play with somebody else.
Wait, who?
Come on, Lorraine. Let's go play some disc golf, just you and me. It'll be fun.
Leave me alone, Biff. I don't want to play with you.
Maybe you do and you just don't know it yet.
Get out of my face!
Hey, you heard her. Yeah, get away. From her.
Yeah, what's it to you, huh? What, are you looking for a fight? Oh. Hey, Alkmaar. Just showing the new guy around the locker room. Hey, look. You're new here, so I'm gonna cut you some slack. Why don't you make like a tree and get it out of here.
George. George, you have got to host that event.
There's no point. Biff is just gonna ruin it again. There's no Rec Room player that can convince me to host another event.
No Rec Room player? Huh.
Who are you? How are you in my dorm?
I am Darth Motivator, a Rec Room dev from Cyberjunk City.
Marty, over here, I need your help. I just posted on Reddit that I'm hosting another coach's dinner party. I need to invite Lorraine, but I'm too nervous to do it.
Hey, listen, keep your shirt on. She's over in the lounge.
Okay.
What made you change your mind, George?
A few minutes ago, Darth Foda Vader from Cyberjunk City came to my dorm, and he said if I did host another coach's dinner party and get Lorraine to attend, that he'd melt my VR headset. He banned me so hard it melt my VR headset. I can't afford another one. You gotta help me.
Yeah, well, let's just keep the headset melting to yourself, okay?
Okay.
There she is, George. All you have to do is go over there and invite her.
Okay, but I don't know what to say.
Tell her Destiny brought you to her. Tell her she's the most talented quest player you've ever seen. People like that stuff.
Destiny? What? I've never played that game. Ooh, but I do play Borderlands.
No, George. Destiny is an... that it was meant to be. Tell her she's destined to go to your event. I'll tell her you have something to ask.
This is good stuff.
Marty, I was hoping you'd get on. There's this crazy ice skating bike that lets you glide around. I tried it, but I got sick.
Yeah, that sounds neat. Hey, my friend has something to say to you. Got this, go.
Lorraine, Borderlands has brought me to you.
What?
What I meant to say was that...
Wait a minute, do I know you from somewhere?
Yes, I'm George. George McFly.
No, your name is floating above your head the same as everyone else.
Oh, right. What I meant to say was... I'm hosting another coach's dinner party mini game this weekend. It's your density to attend. I mean, it's your destiny.
Oh.
Hey, McFly! I just saw your Reddit post saying you're hosting another coach's dinner party. I thought I told you I didn't want you host any more mini games. All right, you don't learn. That's it. I'm vote-kicking you.
Wait, Biff, is that a dev in the audience?
What? I don't see any devs. I just see a lot of bucket heads. Hey, he's using the ice skating bug. After him.
I don't even know how he's doing that.
Hold down your grip button. Hold down your grip button to lean backwards. Slow down! Get back here! Slow down! I'm not gonna hurt you! I'm just gonna foe kick you! Slow down! Feels my parents are gonna be so mad. We just had new carpet. Are we out of bed?
what games does he play?
I don't know, but I'm gonna find out.
Oh, Marty. Here you come in. Constantly get this holotower device of yours working again. I don't know what I've done wrong with it.
Yeah. Listen, Doc, there's...
Oh, never mind.
There's something I need to tell you about the night we recorded that holotower.
Oh, no. Don't tell me. No, it's information about the future, isn't it? No man should know too much of his own destiny.
You don't understand.
I do understand. If I know too much about my own future, I could endanger my Rec Room account, just as you have endangered yours.
You're right.
Now, let me show you my plan to send you home. So, we have this wonderful DeLorean time machine that I will invent. Grammar is so difficult with time travel, I tell you. This DeLorean that we have that I will invent, and it can send you back to the future, but we need 1.21 gigawatts of electricity and power, and we don't have that. We can't get any Rectonium, but as you've told me, an announcement from Coach is due, and that will be able to create the energy we need, right? We just need a way of harnessing that. So, here's my thought. If we get one of those microphones that are available in the lounge, right, and we attach it to the DeLorean with a wire coming down into the flux capacitor, like that, you see, then when you drive the car past the announcement speaker, at just the right time, you'll be able to harness the power from the announcement, you see, and then we'll be able to send you back. So, this is the plan. We outfit the DeLorean with the microphone. Right, runs down into the flux capacitor. A calculated moment. You start off driving from the other side of the locker room, driving directly towards the announcement speaker, accelerating to 8.7 meters per second. Now, according to the flyer, at precisely 5:04 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time, Coach will make that announcement just as the microphone is passing the announcement speaker, thereby directing the 1.21 gigawatts of electricity into the flux capacitor and sending you back to the year 2020.
You sure this will work, Doc?
Oh, no, not at all, but it's worth a try. I mean, if it doesn't, you can just, go the long way. 3 years is not that long. Just play some quests and stuff. You'll be fine. Anyway, I'll take care of this. You take care of your friends. Right, did George invite Lorraine to that Coach's dinner party thing?
Oh, yeah, I think so.
You think so? Well, what did she say? Oh, it's her! Quick, I've gotta erase the plans. Nobody else can see them. It'll break
hi,
the space time continuum.
Lorraine, hi. How'd you know I was in here?
I followed you.
This is my doc. I mean, my friend, Doc Brown.
Marty, I know this may seem kind of forward of me, but I was wondering if you'd like to play Quest together on Friday night? Just the two of us in a private room?
Wow. You mean nobody's invited you to do anything Friday yet?
No, not yet.
Well, what about George's murder mystery event, Coach's dinner party?
Oh, well, I mean, George seems nice and all, but I think a person should be competent and strong-willed and stand up to bullies and protect their friends, don't you?
Yeah.
All right, everyone. We are going to be moving to the second room shortly. Make sure you party up if you're... Did you have a question? I can't hear you, but...
All your questions will be answered, Marty!
Yeah, yeah. So we're not... Okay, please stop with the weapons. Please stop with the weapons. It's very loud. Thank you. We're not done yet. We're about two-thirds of the way through. We have to move to a second room. After the play, after the credits and everything, we will hold a short Q&A for those of you that do have questions. If you make sure you have your orange wristband, it looks unfortunately so similar to the brown one, but I think everyone is partied up and we will go through it. Yes, thank you. Please do not invite other people. If too many people get in the room, it will break the play. We do not want that. Gossip Angel, did you have a question real quick? Oh.
All right, YouTube will get us back in our seats in just a second, okay? Okay, thanks for your patience. Here we go.
I've got my head resting on a pillow.
Ah, shoot. I can't invite the person who dropped out, because I'm not a host. Can you give me host here? I can't seem to invite people here.
They were just playing
Maybe because so it's Chris KRYSS.
I got it.
Yeah.
Give me that again in a sec here.
Oh, you got it, Carthage? Okay.
Thanks, Carthage.
They were in here before. They crashed. Yeah, they were in here before they crashed. Oh, were they?
No, there was two people.
No, they were looking for their seat, I thought. It looked like to me.
No, they were running laps.
Oh, were they? Running laps. Okay. Never mind then.
Yeah, I watched them for a while before I kicked them.
Okay. Yep.
And they stopped in front of the stage and were waving up at the top and things like that. They were...
All right. So did you hear that about your friend? He didn't stay in his seat, so... He was running laps around, getting in front of the stage, being disruptive.
The Gossip Angel as well.
Bamster?
If you can get Chris. Oh, yeah, Chris is...
Yeah, I just did Chris.
I was telling Carthage to get Bamster in here, and you guys both spoke up.
She's probably just loading in.
Okay. My apologies to your friend Bamster. I completely misunderstood because they piped up right as I was asking Carthage to get him in here. Sorry, Bamster.
Okay, here's Chris.
Yes, we are friends. Okay.
Someone said Bamster. Yes, no, is that?
Yes, Bamster.
No,
yes.
The gossip angel. Oh, okay.
I just did the gossip angel.
Yeah,
Bamster and gossip angel are both yes.
Okay.
Someone spell Bamster for me.
Alright.
I mean, I might kill pigeons, so I don't know that I have much room to talk.
Yeah, no problem.
They are not online, Gerhardt. They need to be online.
Yeah, if you want to go ahead and take seats, we're just about to start the second act.
Okay.
Welcome back. Okay, we're just waiting on Bamster now, I believe.
Gerhardt, if you want to tell them. Yeah, Oh, okay. Well,
they're showing offline to all is what's going on.
Well, no, they're online. If they want to come back online, I'll keep an eye out for them, but
You hear that, Snooze?
And Bamster, if you're still there in the audience on YouTube,
your friend Bamster, you said you were on Discord call with him. He's showing his offline to everyone, and we can't get him back in as a result.
Well, they're actually offline.
Oh, they are actually offline. Oh, okay.
Yeah, Chris, okay. I couldn't invite you back in the last room. The room setup was not functional.
Gotcha. Let's see. Yeah, I'm not seeing it. Oh, there he is. I got him. Okay. Wait, I can't invite him. I don't know what. There's some room bugginess going on. He's online now, Carthage. His at name is. Now I can see that. Now he's on my friends list. And he's gone. Yeah, sorry. We're going to have to start the play. He's offline again. There is a YouTube stream if he wants to watch.
I'll keep an eye out.
Okay. All right. Carthage, keep an eye out. Tell your friend to. That's actually Princess Fuzzy.
And she does have a great voice for Doc.
All right. All right, everyone, settle down. And a quick reminder, opening your watch, especially if you're in the front row, is kind of like looking at your phone in a movie theater in real life. It's really bright and distracting for people behind you, for other people. So try not to be putting around your watch just willy-nilly. If you want to quickly invite your friend back or something, that's fine, but don't keep it open if you can avoid that.
Quick update on that. You can't invite your friends.
Right. Yeah, you can't even invite your friends anyways. Izzy? Karthik, did you hear that? Okay.
Message me about it. If you can't get in,
yep.
Send me a friend request. That's fine. Yeah, I'll be in your recent. Send me a friend request or whatever. I'll get you back in the room.
There is Bamster. Right on, just in time. Welcome back, Bamster. Have a seat. And apologies for getting you mixed up with someone else, by the way. All right, let's get Biff back in here, I guess. That airlines guy. Airline guy. Carthage, can you see if airline guy is around? Or drummer? Invites won't work unless you're a drummer or Carthage can use special dead powers to do it.
Yeah, airline guy's offline at the moment, so.
Alright. Must be. Just when he gets online, have him send an invite request to Drummer Geek, and we'll get him back in. Alright. Thank you for being patient with us with the delays at the intermission. I hope you went to the lobby and got some snacks and you know, treats and stuff. We are now going to resume the show. So, hey, Marty, I suggest you get back in your seat, sir. Oh, okay. All right. But I don't understand. How is she gonna be at Coach's here at Coach's dinner party? If she's gonna be playing Quest with you at the same time instead.
Because she wants to go to Coach's dinner party, she just doesn't know it yet. That's why we gotta show her that you, George McFly, are a fighter. That you can stand up to bullies confident enough to run a murder mystery event worth attending.
But I've never picked a fight in my entire life.
You're not going to be picking a fight. You're going to be coming to her rescue, right? Let's go over the plan again. At 4 p.m. Rec Room Standard Time, where are you going to be?
I'm going to be in my dorm.
Right. But where am I going to be?
You're going to be in the locker room with Lorraine.
Right. So, about 4:15, she's gonna get very angry with me because people get upset when they get bucketed.
Whoa! You mean you're gonna put the orange bucket on her head?
Relax. It's just an act, right? Okay. So 4:15, you stroll into the locker room and you see me bucketing her. So you come up to us and you say. You're lying, George.
Hey, you get your damn bucket off her. Do you really think I ought to swear?
Yes, definitely. Coach, damn it, George, swear. Okay, so you come up and vote kick me. Then I get kicked to my dorm, and you and Lorraine go up on a coach's dinner party.
You make it sound so easy. I just wish I wasn't so scared.
There's nothing to be scared of. You just need a high five to give you confidence.
Can I have another?
Yeah. Hey, so, do you mind if we just hang out in here for a little while?
Sure, socializing in the locker room's always nice. You seem nervous. I won't friendly fire you when we play Quest together, I promise.
Lorraine, have you ever been in a situation where you knew you had to act a certain way, but when you got there, you just didn't know if you could go through with it?
I know exactly what you mean.
You do?
Sure. I just don't think about it, and Ask the Devs Unboxing will be released at the Q&A.
Hey! I spent all day cleaning my carpet because of you. I'm gonna vote kick you every time I see you. Y'all better vote yes on the vote kick I just started.
Leave him alone, Beth.
Oh, what do we have here?
Ah! No! Stop! Stop! Leave! Stop! Get that off me!
Hey, you! Leave! Get your damn bucket off!
I think you've got the wrong locker room, McFly. Just turn around
George, help me,
and head back to your dorm.
Please! No! Stop!
What? Are you Deathfly? I said scram!
No, Biff. You leave her alone.
Alright. Alright. Fine.
Biff, stop bullying him! Leave him alone! Leave him alone!
Doc, what are you doing here?
What did you do with Fezzik? Where'd Fezzik go?
That's it, Biff! That's it! I'm... gonna...
You're wearing a bucket is what you're doing. Look, he's an actual buckethead. Where'd she go? You know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna fuck her.
I'm reporting you for harassment!
What? No one in here is gonna vote to kick me.
You just bucketed the entire rec center. Of course they will.
Guys, come on. This is a joke. Don't click yes on
that. Get out of here. I hit yes. Yes.
Are you okay? Let's go to Coach's dinner party together.
I have no idea what happened.
Who knows? Getting bucketed was dumb. There's no music. Someone said there'd be music. This is boring. I'm leaving.
So, how do you play this coach's dinner party? Also, didn't you say there would be a DJ?
Oh, yeah. There's a DJ over there, but I'm sure he'll start playing music anytime. In the meantime, everyone gather around and I'll explain how to play. So we have these cards, and I put them down face down. Everyone look at them.
Sorry, man. My voice meter is busted. I can't play music through the boombox.
But don't tell anyone.
Look, Marvin, you gotta play. And then this is where she plays Murder Mystery for the first time and gets the idea for Minigame Mondays. Yeah. If there's no music, people won't stick around and play the minigame. She won't host her own versions, and she won't post Minigame Monday videos, and then my record account is history.
Sorry, man. Dinner party, come on. Dinner party's over. Unless you know somebody that can DJ.
Yeah, I'm a rec center DJ. Give me the boombox, I got this.
The sheriff.
A rec center, what? You know, actually, you're the DJ. Play something that really cooks.
Something that really cooks.
Hey, Gribbly, it's your favorite Rec Room player. What? No, not Delco. Come on, really? Emily Waffles, yay! Hey, stop it. Anyway, you know that new intro music you've been looking for? Well, listen to this. You, stop it. Listen.
Hey, George, I heard you reported Biff. Good job.
Thanks. He was a buckethead.
Marty, I hope you don't mind, but I asked George if I could host my own coach's dinner party on Monday, so I won't be able to play Quest with you then.
Great. Good. Good, Lorraine. You know, I have a feeling about you hosting minigames.
I've got a feeling, too.
Hey, look, I gotta go. It's been educational.
Marty, I want to thank you for all your good advice. I'll never forget it.
Happy to help. Well, good luck, you guys. One other thing, actually. If Rec Room releases a sequel to Golden Trophy, and one of your friends accidentally goes too far ahead and aggroes the entire bell tower full of goblins, wiping the whole party right before the boss, go easy on him.
Sounds like a mistake anyone could make. Right, Lorraine? I come on, we can forgive that.
Or healthy moose.
Damn, where is that kid? Damn, he's late. Ah, there you are, Marty. Oh, have you no sense of time? You're late.
The locker room is full. It wouldn't let me in until someone left.
Ah, yeah, of course. That would have been you got sent to your dorm room, didn't you? I saw you get road kicked. That was hilarious. Oh. Anyway, welcome back. Now...
Yeah, you were there. Yeah, when George reported and vote kicked Biff, remember? I didn't know he had it in. He never stood up to Biff.
I left before that happened, but I saw you get vote kicked, and that was hilarious. I tell you, man.
Oh, man.
Very funny. Anyway, let's get this organized. We're running out of time. We're gonna get you back to the future. Go.
I didn't know that George even had that in it. He's never stood up to Biff before.
Never?
No. Wait, why? What's the matter?
Oh, never mind. Anyway, we're running out of time. Come on, let's get this organized. We'll set your destination time. I'm going to send you back to the exact moment from which you came. There we go. Now, you go way over there by the ping pong table. That's where you'll start from. I've taken into account the precise distance needed for you to get up to 8.7 meters per second when you're passing that announcement speaker, right as Coach announces the update. So when I ring this bell here, you hit the gas. Got it?
Right. Thanks, Doc.
Thank you. Okay. See you in a few years then.
I hope so.
Don't worry. As long as you pass that speaker with the microphone attached at precisely 8.7 meters per second, the instant Coach makes the announcement, everything will be fine.
Right.
Oh, what is the meaning of this email you've sent me entitled, "Don't Open for 3 Years"?
You'll find out in 3 years.
Oh, it's information about the future, isn't it? I've warned you about this, kid. The consequences could be disastrous.
Yeah, well, that's a risk you're going to have to take, because your life depends on it.
No! I refuse to accept the responsibility. I'm going to mark it as spam.
You know what? In that case, I'll just tell you straight out.
Hey.
No, don't tell me. No man should know too much about his own destiny.
Hey, look what happens when I find darkness busy here.
No, don't do that! No! Oh! No!
Oh! Oh no!
Nothing else!
Sorry.
What have you done?
I'm sorry.
You've ruined everything! Okay. Well, stick to the plan. Marty, we're running out of time. You get in the car. You get on over there. I'll try and get this speaker back up where it needs to be so we can...
I'm sorry!
Yeah. Oh, I can't reach high enough for to get up there.
Damn it, Doc. Why'd you have to put that email in the spam folder? Only a more time. Wait a minute, I have all the time I need. I have a time machine. I can just go back 10 minutes earlier and warn him.
Alright, here we are. Now this is right. Let's go. And I'll just balance there. Just that's how it was, wasn't it? Just like that. Oh, bah, coach, damn it! Great Scott! Oh, I really gonna have to get up there, but I can't. Oh, you there, help me, Bruce! Come down here right now. This is all your fault.
I'm coming. I'm here.
Hi. You are clearly an underage child. I could report you for being on an adult account and get you condemned to a junior account, never to speak again. Is that what you want?
Yeah, I won't have to never speak again. Once I turn 13, I'll get an adult account.
Oh, I don't know. That seems like it's quite a long time away. I don't think you want to wait that long, do you?
Come on. No, well, I don't. I'm like,
here's the offer then, Healthy Moose. Here's the other option. Instead of reporting you, how about you help me solve this mess that you have caused? Huh? You think you can do that?
Okay, please don't report me. What do you mean?
All right, now you see this bell here?
Yes, that bell. So what I do is I come to the locker room, I stare at the bell, I hit it, and then I get happy. Isn't that a great story?
Excellent. Yes, that definitely shows that you understand how to operate a bell. Very good.
You just hit now, it. It's so easy. Anyone can do it.
Yes, but...
But I do it the best.
That's good. Okay, I'm glad that you're very good at this. I need someone to hit the bell because I need to get up there and hold this speaker in place.
So you didn't,
I won't be able to reach the bell from up there. I need you to get in the booth and just like in the story you told me, stare at that bell and get ready to hit it.
Okay, but why? You got it? Why am I doing it? If I'm doing something so important and I'm so important, you gotta tell me why.
There's no time to explain.
But you're literally talking right now. You could just tell me. Literally. Yes.
No,
come on.
I only have time to tell you that there's no time to tell you. I'm sorry, but this is the way it goes.
You could have told me what it is by saying
bell?
In that
get
time.
Ready.
You said
the time is almost here. 57, 58,
you're not even
59.
Telling me
okay,
why.
Okay, hit it now. Yes,
okay.
Yes, Healthy Moose, hit the bell.
Attention. A new update well is available.
What?
Please quit Rec Room and download the update.
What? Oh,
what?
Yes. Oh, what did
happened?
I tell you?
The ground is on fire. The ground is on fire. The car exploded.
Yes,
what
huge
happened?
Success. Make a note here.
Oh, I didn't know.
What did
it?
The child has been disappeared. Into the future. He's gone.
What?
3 years. I don't have to deal with
what
that child.
What am I
going to
do? Oh, what did I do?
The new rec center! This is beautiful. Everything's beautiful. The color seems kind of off, though. The merch booth! Oh, man, it looks great. The lumberjacks!
Okay, what? Okay, look. Using hacks to bring stuff into the rec center is not okay, alright? I'm giving you a 10-minute timeout.
Wait, just one second. I can explain. Just...
Explain what? I'd like to know how he did this. That'd be nice.
I'll
Let's see you keep up with this. Doc! No. No. You're alive! A paintball shield! How did you know? I never got a chance to tell you.
Ah, you see, I recovered that email from my spam folder.
What about all the talk about screwing up future events in the space-time continuum?
Well, I figured, what the hell?
So how far ahead are you going?
Oh, I figure about 3 years to a nice triangular number.
Yeah, well, look me up when you get there, okay? I'll probably be about level 47.
Oh, yeah, right. I mean, yes, yeah, of course you will be, yeah, you got.
Take care. Oh, and watch that re-entry. It's a little laggy right now.
Oh, I will. Thank you, buddy.
I think we need a rematch, George.
A rematch? Why? Were you cheating?
No. Good morning.
Hello.
George, Lorraine. Oh, you guys look great. Lorraine, that dress is fantastic.
Right?
Why, thank you, Marty. Oh, I almost forgot. Jennifer was asking about you. Isn't tonight the night of the big date?
What?
Aren't you two going to the lake? You've been planning it for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
We talked about this. The car's wrecked.
Wrecked?
Wrecked? When did this happen?
Hang on, I'm sure the car's just fine. See? Here's Biff waxing it right now. Now, Biff, make sure you get this elbow spot. I accidentally just smudged it right there. And I want 2 coats of wax this time, not just one.
Well, first off, I'm charging the extra for that. I'm just finishing up the second coat now.
Mm-hmm. Now, Biff, don't con me. There was no wax right there.
And what is an elbow? Regardless, I'm just starting on the second.
2 coats, Biff. 2 coats, not just one.
Gotcha. Starting the second coat now.
Ah, Biff. What a character. You know, I've had to keep an eye on him since before the PSVR beta. Although, if it wasn't for him...
we never would have created all of our awesome minigames for the community.
That's right.
Hey guys, check out this new bug I just added. Walking and teleport at the same time. Here's the plan.
Oh,
we're gonna put it in, and then a week later, we're gonna take it out. It's so evil.
That sounds like a feature.
I feel sick just thinking about that.
Wait, I thought you were banned.
No, that's great. Banned. Hey. Marty, why would I be banned? I work for Rec Room. I just add bugs like that all day.
Yeah, he's literally a dev, Marty.
I was just coming to tell you they announced the contest results. You won.
Well?
Hooray.
Yeah, I told you I would.
Oh, hey, Marty, your new truck's all waxed up and ready for the big date. I parked it outside the kitchen.
Wait, truck?
Yes. Outside the kitchen.
Whoa.
Hey,
How about a ride, mister?
Jennifer! Are you a sight for sore eyes? Let me look at you.
Marty, you're acting like you haven't seen me in a week.
I haven't.
What? Marty, are you feeling okay? You alright? Marty? Yeah.
Everything's great.
Okay. Marty, where are you going?
Marty! Marty, you've got to come back with me!
Where?
Back to the future!
What is he talking about, Marty?
What are you doing, Doc?
I need fuel! Come on, quick, get in the car! We're gonna go!
Where are you going? Marty?
No!
Come on!
No! I just got here, okay? Jennifer's here. We're gonna take my new truck for a spin.
No, that's not gonna work. The truck doesn't have a flux capacitor. We have to go in this one. Come on, let's go. Bring her along. This concerns her too.
Why? What happens to us in the future? Do we turn into mirror dwellers or something?
Oh, no. You two turn out just fine. It's your little brother and her younger sister. They get your accounts banned by association. Come on, we're gonna go!
Hey, Doc, we better back up. We don't have enough stage to reach 8.7 meters per second.
Stage? Where we're going? We don't need stage!
Where are we? When are we?
Oh, we are in the future, the year 2023!
What? So you weren't kidding about time travel? Huh.
Yes, Marty, Jennifer, your siblings and Biff's younger brother Griff should be here any minute now. Whatever happens, you need to stop them, your siblings, from playing with Griff, right? Remember, don't let them know that you're related to them, or you might break the space-time continuum!
Oh, right. Don't break space-time.
That's so weird, space I don't think,
time.
Like,
right.
Clothes are so old. Funny.
Hey, you two. Let's team up and go to Rec Royale solos.
We should go to squads instead.
But they just released the Bear Keeper outfit, and I want it before anyone else. Cheating is the only way I can do that. Now, come on.
Cheating is wrong, though. We shouldn't do it. What if we get caught?
What's the matter, Healthy Moose? Chicken?
Don't call me chicken. My name is Healthy Moose. You got it right the first time. But right,
come on, let's go.
Hey, maybe you kids play. That I don't know. Hey, you shouldn't cheat. Just go play squads if you want to team up.
You're right, Mr. Person I also don't know. Let's go team up and go play squads. Bye, Griff.
Thanks a lot, bucketheads. How am I supposed to get the Bear Keeper outfit now?
You know, Griff, you sound pretty young. Are you 7?
I'm not 7, I'm 11. I'm gonna report you for being bucketheads.
Not if we report you for being underage first.
Hey, you can't do that. That's cheating. That's not allowed.
Bye-bye. There he goes.
Well, disaster averted, I guess. What do we do now?
Yeah. Oh, I hadn't really thought that far. It was a lot easier than I expected it to be.
Well, we could play this Wild West quest.
Cowboys are not really my style, you know. What else?
Hey, Doc, you once said the future's whatever you make it, so make it a good one, right?
Yes, well said, Marty. How about Jumbotron 2.0, then? I hear they have wreck savers. Yes.
Sounds great.
Yeah, let's do it.
Thank you. Thank you, all of you. And thank you to everyone watching on YouTube. We hope you all enjoyed the show. A huge thank you to the Rec Room developers for allowing us to use their sounds and music, as well as for creating this wonderful game and the UGC tools used to perform this play. We would also like to give a thank you to the band I Fight Dragons for giving us permission to use their version of the song, The Power of Love. That's this song playing right now. And now, to introduce the cast and crew. I kill pigeons as George. George Yay. The Fly. I play Borderlands.
Yeah. Ew.
Yeah. Eric as Marty.
Woo.
Woo.
Oh.
Yay. Great job.
Yay.
Wait, yay.
Just me as Jennifer and Lorraine's friend. Great job,
Jasmine. Woo! Yay! Boo! Over. Why are you booing me, Jasmine?
I didn't woo!
Oh, I said boo. I didn't woo.
It's okay, you can boo Jasmine. No, you, no, no, don't boo Jasmine. I'm sorry, I didn't.
Boo!
Princess Fuzzy! Not Eric.
Yeah.
Princess Fuzzy as Dr. Emmett Brown.
Yeah.
Carthage. Carthage did a lot of our plays. Not tonight. And Biff's Goon Fezzik, as well as Biff's Goon Dr. Emmett Brown.
He's not getting paid, though.
He was freelance. That's a pretty funny thing to do to people in the rec center, I tell you. Oh, hilarious. Yeah, that was a funny moment, that, I tell you.
Mama Monkey as herself.
Yeah.
Oh wait, no, not as herself. Mama Monkey as Lorraine.
Lorraine. Yeah.
In case you haven't figured it out, Lorraine's character was based on Mama Monkey. Drummer Geek. This is where you can boo. As this is good.
Why did you try to bucket me in the show? I did nothing wrong, and yet you tried to bucket me. Boo!
No!
Alright, Drummer Geek also created the theater, all of our sets, and designed all of our circuits. Drummer Geek and I also co-directed this production. Oh yeah. And I wrote the script. I forgot to mention that for me, didn't I? Alright.
I mean, you mentioned it in the lobby, but...
Did I?
He likes to mention that a lot.
Yeah.
I must, yes. Someone else
He's actually
must
very humble.
I am very humble, yeah. Well, sometimes.
Really humble.
Sometimes.
So
I mean,
humble.
Let me just say, it's been really hard to play George, because he's so out of my element.
Are you bragging about how humble you are?
Yes. I might be a humble brag.
Come on,
you didn't even finish the credits,
moving on.
You're already bragging. Good job.
Moving on. Star Centurion as Watts, a lumberjack paintballer. Ranger Roy, Zhang Yi, Marvin, and Marty's younger brother.
Yay!
Yay!
Emily Waffles, yay! As
yay.
Literally herself, as well as a lumberjack paintballer. Emily the bartender.
Yay!
Yay!
Alkmaar. And what is easily the best character in the show, let's be honest. Big cheer Woo! For Healthy Moose.
Yeah.
Big cheer for Buckethead Healthy Moose. Delco, the sound technician.
Delco.
How many people are keeping these buckets?
They're big buckets.
I got
big
so.
Buckets. Joker, the control board operator.
Yeah.
Where is he?
He always comes from a different spot. I don't know.
Where is he?
Joker? Where far are thou?
Where'd he
Joker.
Go?
Joker.
Joker. Joker. Joker. Joker. Joker. Joker.
Joker.
Damn, don't, Fuzzy, stay. You don't need to be thinking this.
Stay hidden, Joker. Biff is gonna bucket you.
He's in here somewhere.
All right.
Obviously, he doesn't want to be seen. Let's move on.
And special guest star Carthage playing himself.
Yeah.
You heard, catch me.
Oh yeah. Where did he go?
Out of nowhere.
Yeah, can't get up here.
And shout out.
We're safe. Oh, there's and shout out to there's Joker. There's Joker. Hey,
there he is. He was there the whole time. What are you guys talking about?
He's vulnerable to being bucketed.
And shout out to Gearheart for filming
I can hear y'all now, by the way. Hi, friends.
Oh, finally.
Finally.
Yay. Together we are the Orange Bucket Act Troop. Thank you.
Thanks for coming out, everybody.
You're welcome.
Never gets old.
Wow, there were a couple scenes, including the credits, that kind of went off the rails there, didn't they?
Yeah, that was a very free-form version of the show.
Oh, man.
Yes. All right, everybody. Everybody, if y'all could just turn around and say goodbye to the YouTube stream. Everybody look at the camera and say bye.
Bye.
Bye, YouTube.
Bye, YouTube.